This is really the sort of classic fancy of a Sotheby specialist. My colleague in Paris one day gets a phone call from the lady telling him she has this vase that's been sitting in an attic for a couple of decades and she would like to bring it in. She took it on the train, in a shoebox, on the RER in Paris and walked over to the office. There it came out of the box. One of the finest, most dazzling pieces of famous porcelain we have ever seen. And it turns out this is a seal mark of the Qianlong Emperor, the most powerful human being who lived on Earth in the 18th century. It is a vase that was probably made for his birthday on the 34th year of his reign and decorated with a great wealth of auspicious designs from pine trees that signify longevity to Lu, the deer, which is happiness, to the cranes that wish for old age. What's exceptional, I would say, on this vase is the quality of the firing. It must have been positioned just right in the kiln and fired on for just the right amount of time because the colors have come out pin sharp. So you have that gem-like dazzling appearance that you do not often see. In its shape and design, it's a unique vase and it's very closely related to one of the most famous pieces in a public collection in France. So it's a very exciting opportunity for collectors around the world. I hope it's not just a once-in-a-lifetime experience, the discovery of an object of this quality, of this importance. That's what we live for here at Sotheby's.
And that's the story, how this amazing vase found its way into Sotheby's auction in Paris just this week. Quite a thing. I doubt the woman riding on the train had any idea what she was carrying. She must have been thrilled. But the vase's history and the design itself and the origins of it for Qianlong's birthday in 1770 make this all a really fascinating story. The colors on this pot, as Mr. Chow pointed out, are just unbelievable. Very strong. I think it's better than the one in the Guimet, and I've seen the one in the Guimet. This one is more vibrant. The shading and so forth is unbelievable. It was this painting technique, of course, was introduced to the Chinese by heavily influenced by Giuseppe Castiglione, who was a favorite of the Qianlong Emperor, and he painted this portrait here of Qianlong in 1739, in his fourth year of his reign, when he was reviewing his eight banner troops, and you can see how Western that painting looks. And here is another scene of horses that he did. This was a fairly large painting. This is just part of it. But he excelled at painting horses. Just spectacular. All right. And the workmanship that went into this vase was developed mostly during the period of Tang Ying, who ran the supervisor of the imperial kilns up until about 1756. And here's the last look at the bottom of it and another side shot. All right. And now the question is, and there's a lot of rumors going around about who bought it. Nobody's saying so far, but here's a hint who the front runner is in the rumor mill on this. It's the same fellow that bought the chicken cup. But time will tell. Nobody has said anything yet, but that's just a rumor. But it's a pretty strong rumor. So we'll see. If he bought it, you'll be hearing about it. All right. Have a great week, and see you next time. Bye-bye. And in a world apart is bloom.
And when you speak, angels sing from above. Everyday words seems to turn into love song. Give your heart and soul to me, and life will always bleed. Love, be unrolled.